Hello, citizens of New Babbage and every other place in the galaxy. This is Dubarkis. Welcome to Star Citizen. Welcome to my channel. We are still at New Babbage. This is day 4 of the International Aerospace Expo, IAE 2951. Today is for the alien ships Alpoa, Banu, Esperia, and Gatak Manufacture.
Capsule now approaching station. Stand clear of disembarking passengers.
So it's 2 stops. If I remember correctly. Okay. No time to waste. Let's quickly head to the elevators. All right, that's the right place. Okie dokie, let's take a look at the screen here. So, the Gatak Rylan and the Banu Merchantman are gonna be at the basement. And here we just, today we have very, very few ships to explore. Alright, so it's gonna be very easy. We have the Banu Defender, we have the Xperia Blade, we have the Xperia Glaive, the Prowler, the Hatual, the Talon, and the Talon Shrike. And they are all at the same place, so let's go, because the day is about to change. Oh my goodness, this is... I cannot overemphasize the beauty of this place. Borrowed freely, okay? Let's see. What does it say?
It's not uncommon for human manufacturers to offer unique features and designs to make their ships stand out from the crowd. But the Banu take a slightly different approach when it comes to crafting their vehicles. Heavily and freely borrowing from each other and even other species, Banu ships are made by combining the best features and best technology they can get their hands on.
Alright, you heard that. What's here? Okay, that's the same thing. Now, this one is the Banu Defender, I believe. Let's look at the ship first, and then we'll come to read the description they've given it. This is one of the very beautiful alien ships. We'll go inside this one, because this thing is beautiful. It's not my kind of ship, but it's beautiful. The alien design is breathtaking. Let's open it. And I've never been inside it before. It's been only on... I've seen it on videos. Right. I believe there should be an opening somewhere. It has a left and right left and right doors. Yep. So it has two cockpits. I believe you can fly it from either of the cockpits. Look at that. So here are the two cockpits. You can see the windows, the left and right ones. I love the gold. Now, you probably know or probably don't, the ships can be rented for free throughout the expo. All ships are rentable and cost you nothing. Okay, so that's that. That's the cockpit. And this has actually much more visibility than I imagined it would have. Wow, I didn't even know you could actually see all the way to the back. Alright, this is cool. This is cool. This is my first time being inside this ship. And I'm liking it. Alright, let's head out. And it's kind of dark, and I don't have my flashlight with me, so the same way it is over there, it is here too. You can see. I don't want to sit down. So that's that for the Banu Defender. This is actually a beautiful ship. You can pause and read it. Next one over here is the Esperia Blade. So this is how you enter the ship. I think you enter it from the bottom. Alright, so that's the blade for you. And it's nimble. And I don't like it. Like, I don't like to own these kinds of ships that look like organisms. They give me the jeepers creepers. So let's head out here. Goodness. I already feel sick. You see how you get inside of it. And the next one of my favorites, the Aupoa Hatual. I used to own this ship, but I sold it to get a better one. I might get it back in the future, who knows. So probably this one is a replica of the real one, you know, the sizes of the species, humans and the Xian are different, so this one has to be modified for human use. And this ship is beautiful. Let's see, just take a look at how you enter it. Is that not awesome?
Collection of beverages and tasty snacks are available for purchase in the lobby.
Look at that. Alright. It's another nimble ship. Because of the location of the engines. And when you take off, it basically stands up on its tip. Well, it doesn't stand up, but it goes vertical. I love the color. It's very beautiful. And it has two size 2 guns. I believe those are size 2 size 2 repeaters. Alright, so let's head out. Okay, that's the Alpoa Hartual. Look at the engines. Oh my goodness. There are four of them. Now let's go to the Prowler. I think some of these things are there's a glitch and they're partially buried. I don't think that's how it ends, but that's okay. This ship, I also don't really like it because it looks like an insect. Anything that looks like an organism, I don't really like. Now, how do you get inside this ship? I believe it's from the back. Yeah, Esperia Prowler. I'm probably not clicking the right spot. Okay, now I get it. Finally. Alright, that's it. Everything looks so creepy here. The color, everything. Now, this is a dropship, so you can drop people here, and even when you open this, you still have a force field. You have a force field, so the vacuum of space would not enter. I believe you can still stay inside here without your helmet and not die because of the force fields. But this is how you stand in the ship. You don't sit down. That's the cockpit. Alright, also has a screen, and the screen is off, so we can't really see anything. Power on.
Systems activating. Systems on.
Yeah, ordinarily when you turn it on, the screen should light up. The
systems off.
The digital window. Alright, let's head out. And that's the same thing with the Talon over there, except the internal missile racks. So that's the same thing right there. There's always somebody there. I like the green color, but that's the only thing I like in this. I just don't like the ships that look like animals. And I have never been inside this ship, so I don't really know how to enter it. I believe it's from the back, though. But I might be wrong. Oh, actually, hold on. I see. Oh my goodness. All right, that's beautiful. This one also does not have a camera, does not have a window. Has cameras, and let's see if it will turn on. And it's not turning on. I think the power is already on. Oh, hold on. What's that? Okay, it's quantum display on. Navigation display. Okay, that's not the screen. Power on.
Systems activating. Systems on.
All right, the systems turn on, but the screen does not. So, usually when it is on, this whole place will become a screen. It looks like a digital window that you can see the outside from. All right, let's head out. Unfortunately, that's all we can see, and I don't own the ship. I don't plan to rent it. It creeps me out. That over there is the glaive, Hesperia glaive. Another one I don't know how to get inside of, because I've only fought these ships. I've never owned them. I don't intend to. I hate them. Let's see. See how you enter it? You don't sit down on these ships. You lie down. And there we go. This is a very hard ship to beat in combat. It's a very solid ship. Looks like a devil, actually. Okay, this is another ship that's been modified for human use. It's not, of course, the Vanduul are much bigger than humans. All right, let's go. Can pause and read it. Right, let's move on. What's the next one? Actually, I think I got them all. as far as the ships are concerned. Is there any other ship I haven't seen here?
Manufacturers and ships on display? The all-new 2951 IAE immersive audio experience.
Okay, so we saw the Blade, we saw the Banu Defender, the Glaive, the Prowler, the Hatual, the Talon, and the Talon Shrike. Okay, we've seen them all. Alright, let's head downstairs. Okay, here we have the Banu Merchantman and the Gatak Rylan. Alright, that's the Merchantman. Of course, it's much bigger than this, it's just a hologram. A very huge ship. Very huge. What does it say? Alright, that's the Banu. I thought there was a thoroughfare. Oh, there is. It's kind of confusing in the dark. And here we have the Gatak. There's the cockpit. It's a beautiful ship. I had the red, the purple one, sold it, but I might get it back, who knows. So let's head back out. This is the Yellow Jacket GT210 Gatling. This is the M4A cannon. And that looks like the Sawbuck. What's that? Okay, Tarantula GT870 Mark 1 cannon. This looks like a Hurston Dynamics. Yep. That's the attrition 2 repeater. It's probably a size 2. These are huge. Why not experience it firsthand with the test flight? These look like alien, of course. It's Hesperia. And that's the Light Strike 6 cannon. Probably the... Well, I don't know. I don't know who, what ship has it. Wait, what was that? 6. Okay, size 6. This should be a size 5. Light strike, alright, it goes down size 4, size 3, size 2, and size 1. Yep. Alright, that's a city area.
Invite everyone to join in and help keep our halls looking their best.
These ones we already saw, M5A cannon, it's a size 5 gun.
And deposit any waste in the appropriate receptacles. Thanks!
In order to to be daring, one must take risks. Having the right tools can make the difference between success and failure. By selecting a high-quality, expertly crafted weapons system, even a top-of-the-line vehicle can have their strengths honed to the next level and become a decisive force ready to face any obstacle head-on. From defensive options to heavy-duty stopping power, the IAE armament gallery is bound to have the weapon upgrade you've been looking for. Alright, that was a mouthful, and it was in all caps. It's easier to read normal case. This is the Pyroburst Scattergun, made by A&R Armaments. Okay, and over there should have... Oh, these are guns too?
Whether it's stepping into an unknown system, or coasting the well-traveled routes of the
home. Looks like the guns we already saw the previous day. I mean, on the center, but at the walls, these are alien guns, I believe. Yeah, that's Xperia. That's Xperia. Deadbolt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Should be Deadbolt 6. Let's see.
Attention visitors to the Intergalactic Aerospace Expo. Please remember to stay hydrated while exploring.
Alright, so that's it. These places look like they are closed because there's nothing going on in those rooms, so the whole area is blocked off. And here we have the components. Okay, it looks like it's the same things that we've seen before. Yep, it is.
Ready to learn more about the manufacturing.
Oh, okay. Yesterday we didn't see these. This is the FR-86. Can use this in the 400i. I know because I got it a few days ago. This is the full block. These are shield generators, by the way. Which one is this? This is the parapet. Okay. Which one is this? Ultra Flow? Ice Flush. This one, Tempest. And Tempest.
This is a friendly reminder that the Tobin Exoskeleton is shared.
This one is by
Juno Stavec.
Alright, these are... I believe these are... power plants, and these are jump drives. Which one is this? This is the Balandine, and this is the same thing. And this one is what is it? The Agni. Right. I don't know what ships take those.
Due to heightened security measures in the scanning system.
All right, I think that's all there is to see. Oh, actually, there are stuff here too.
If you see anything,
that's the cloak. These are shield generators.
Thank you.
The Obscura. The Veil. The Citadel. These are by Basilisk. Alright, Ascension Astro. Alright, well, these are shield generators, and these are... what are these? I saw this in that... in one of those ships.
Sapphire. This
looks like a jump drive.
Appropriate receptacles. Thanks!
Yeah, I think they're jump drives. This one, Bolt. Yeah, it's a jump drive. Huracán and Colossus, all jump drives. Here we have coolers, Zero Rush,
whether it's innovative special craft, reliable workforce,
permafrost,
tried and true defenders. The Intergalactic Aerospace Expo is where spaceship enthusiasts come to take flight.
Echo Flow, Absolute Zero. Wow, these are very tiny coolers for very tiny ships. Wow, those look like they're very. They look like you can put them in your pocket.
Then why not experience it firsthand with a test flight?
Christ,
many of the vehicles on display at this year's IAE
every vehicle is unique. Every vehicle is unique. Any experienced pilot will tell you that two ships of the same make and model will have their own personality and quirks. It's what makes being a pilot so exciting and so challenging, and it is why component customization is so important to help your vehicle be the very best it can. The items on display at this year's IAE component showcase will help you find the perfect.
Please remember to stay hydrated while exploring.
Will help you to find the perfect balance between defense, offense, and function. Between defense, offense, and function. That's it. So let's head back out.
Did you discover the craft of your dreams at this year's IAE? Then why not experience it firsthand with the test flight? Many of the vehicles.
All right, guys, that's all we have for day 5. For day 4. Today's day 4, right? Where's the TV? We didn't get to see the TV today. Let's see what they have here. That looks like the Defender. Yep, that's the Defender.
Whether it's innovative specialty craft, reliable workforces, or tried and true defenders, the Intergalactic Aerospace Expo is the biggest on the team.
With courage!
And that's the Prowler.
Live events and exhibitions.